let's go to the next question. चलें आगे बढ़े. ठीक है. चलो next question. We keep it simple only. No difficult questions today. This is a rod of mass M and length L. Okay, two strings are there. Alright? Everything is symmetrical. Properly the message it is there. Alright? Now this string is cut suddenly. Immediately after cutting, what is the tension on this string? Immediately after cutting. Have you got the answer? That's not correct. No. It will be like that only. Immediately after cutting, it will be exactly the way it is before cutting.
Is it 7 mg wafer? 7 mg
wafer.
How? I wrote all over. Like you have to talk and hang back.
Something like this you have to do. You have E minus this, mg minus this will be equal to mg2L.
So is it 3mg by 2L?
It will be what?
3mg by 2L.
That's
not mg.
Yeah.
Achha, tell me, immediately after cutting, will there be accretion of center of mass?
Immediately
after cutting, is there a torque?
Yes.
Before cutting, was there a torque?
No.
No. So when I cut it, tension becomes zero this way.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is a fixed axis of rotation immediately after cutting. There is a torque because of mg. How much is the torque?
Mg L by 2.
This should be equal to? I is ml square by 3 into alpha. So alpha is what?
3g by 2l.
3g by 2l. So acceleration of center of mass is what? This into alpha by, this into l by 2. So this is 3g by 4. This is ACM. Any doubt? Now draw the free body diagram. This is tension, this is mg, and there is ACM. So I can write mg minus t is equal to m into 3g by 4. So t is equal to mg by
minus mg by 4. It should be minus.
Kya minus?
Sir, minus m in 3g by 4. Because it's the same direction. Mg and
no, mg and mg minus t is m into ACM.
So but they're in the same direction.
What same direction?
Mg and
That is acceleration.
This is not force.
It's acceleration.
Force equal to mass and acceleration I'm writing.
L into
okay. So we know the concept. Knowing a concept and applying the concept are two different things. Okay.
So, as it keeps moving till the
dead still rises. What dead will? No, after this something weird will happen. But I am asking immediately after cutting. No doubt, right? Go down here. Take it. Alright. Next question. It's a cylinder which acts like a pulley. M1, M2, stop talking. Mass M and radius R. This is a cylinder. The pulley is a cylinder. And there is a friction between the cylinder and the thread. thread doesn't slip on the cylinder. Okay, thread doesn't slip on the cylinder. You need to find out everything, acceleration and tension.
The friction coefficient is given.
Friction is enough for no slipping. Acceleration and tension you have to find. System is rotating, why not it will rotate? This is the real thing. What we have been doing was the ideal scenario where pulley is massless, frictionless, pulley doesn't even rotate if it is frictionless. Pulley will rotate only when there is a torque, right? And if it is frictionless, there is nothing to apply friction. Will tension both sides be same or not?
Yeah.
No. Same thing, same tension without friction. That's a complete sentence. Okay, there is a friction on the string. Alright, so please remember that if the cylinder has mass and it has moment of inertia and it is rotating, tension will be different at both sides. Oh, he is selling like cylinder is mass per by 2. Kyun tu uska mass per bola?
This is solid cylinder.
Arey pulley kaisa rahega? Pulley
why can't it be a?
No, it can be hollow, correct. But what I said last class, if I just say sphere, it means solid sphere.
That's
small. Acceleration of the masses and the tension in the string. Should I do it? This is T1, this is T2. On the cylinder, it will be T1 this way and T2 that way. From here to here, it is same tension. From here to here, it is same tension. But because the friction is there, it makes T1 and T2 different. Okay? And let's say it is coming down with acceleration A, this moves up. What is the acceleration of this block? A only, because of constraint. Okay. Equation likho but fatafat, you don't need to solve.
A is 0.
I got
it. So A is 0, right?
Huh?
A is 0.
Sure?
What?
It moves, it rotates. Center rotates.
Wait, no, so there's something wrong. Wait one second. So there's something wrong.
Yes.
I'll change it. I'll change it. I got it now.
What is the force applied on the cylinder?
T1 plus T2 plus MG.
Suppose if I cut this. Isko maine cut kar diya. Like this. What is the force applied on the cylinder? T1 and T2? T1 and T2 only, right? I am considering cylinder plus that string on it as one system. I am not removing string. If you remove the string, friction will come in as an external force. And friction will be equal to the tension only. Because friction will be equal to mass in acceleration of the string, okay, and mass of the string we are assuming to be zero, okay, so net force has to be tension only on the string, equal and opposite it will be, okay. So the equation on equation of M1 will be what? M1G minus T1 is equal to what?
M1A.
M1A. What about M2?
M2.
T2 minus
minus M2G equals M2A.
M2A. Right? Now, this cylinder rotates. Torque will do I alpha. Is there a fixed axis? Yes. Fixed axis as well as center of mass axis both coincide. Best thing. So it will be, torque will be what? I have to take sense of rotation like this to make it consistent with A. If A is down, it has to rotate like this. It can't rotate in other direction. Getting it that way, you have to maintain the consistency. So T1 into R is torque because of T1. What about T2? Minus or plus?
Minus.
T1 tries to rotate like this. T2 tries to rotate in opposite direction. So T1R minus T2R is equal to I alpha. I is what?
MR
square by 2 into alpha.
Yeah.
Okay? And alpha into R is A. Why? Because this point is moving in a circle with respect to that fixed point. So alpha into R is the acceleration of that point. So alpha into R is A. That's all. It solves the question. Okay. Any doubts? No doubts. Okay, over here, this is a sphere. Sphere kept on the inclined plane. The friction is sufficient for it to not to slip. Pure rolling. Find out the force of friction between the inclined plane and the sphere.
Two by five.
2 by 5 mR square is moment of inertia.
So that it doesn't slip.
It is rolling without slipping. What is the force of friction? Mu is not given. Done.
Wait, so
another friction.
Do you need to find coefficient of friction?
Sin theta minus 5 by 2.
Coefficient of friction or full friction force?
Friction force acting on it should be what? So that it rolls without slipping.
Is it phi mg by 2 R?
More than mg. Mg R sin theta.
So is it 5g sin theta by 2 R?
No. Torque is equal to
force.
Which force? Friction?
Yeah.
So 2 by 5 mg sin theta will be the answer.
No, yeah, you're light.
Go.
So is it mg into sin theta minus 5 cos theta?
All right, I'll do it now. There will be mg force, there will be normal force. Friction will be in which direction?
Upwards.
So that it start rolling like this. You have to look at the rotation as well. This is the force of friction. Okay. Any other force that we have missed? No other force, right? So, which force, are you seeing any fixed axis? Bottommost point is instant inertia at rest. But at times, we don't feel comfortable treating at this as a fixed axis. So, we'll apply torque into I alpha about the center of mass. So, which force has a torque about center of mass? Mg passes through the center of mass or not? So, torque due to Mg is 0. Torque due to normal direction? 0. Only friction will have torque. So, if friction is not present, alpha can never happen. Alpha can never be there. It will just slide down. It will not rotate because torque will be 0 about center of mass. Okay? So, R into Fr is a torque about center of mass. This should be equal to what? 2 by 5? 2 by 5 mR square. So, into alpha. So, Fr is 2 by 5 m alpha into R. Now, this is rolling without flipping on a fixed surface. So alpha into R is ACM. We have done that. Right? So, friction will be equal to 2 by 5 m into A center of mass. Okay? Now, I have to find ACM. Okay? So, if I take component of mg, stop talking, mg sin theta minus fr is equal to what? M into A. Right? I'll substitute friction value over there. So, I'll get mg sin theta minus 2 by 5 m into A. This m is gone. 7 by 5 A, so A is 5 by 7 G sin theta. Understood?
Yeah.
This is efficient of center of mass. This when you substitute over there, you will get force of friction to be equal to 2 by
7 G sin theta.
2 by 7 mg sin theta. This is what they call rolling friction. Only this much friction is required for it to roll without slipping. The maximum possible friction is mu into normal direction, which happens because of sliding. And if it is rolling without slipping, this much will be the friction acting on it, which is very less. Any doubts?
So we can also do this by balancing torque about that point at the bottom.
There is no balance torque.
Yeah,
alpha
so
is there.
Over there.
About this you can write the torque. Mg sin theta into R is equal to moment of inertia about this axis into alpha.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
You can't use about that axis moment of inertia.
That's why. Okay.
But then don't do like that. Because it is a fixed axis, but it doesn't appear to be a fixed axis. So every time when you do like that, you will not be feeling in control of the problem. Any other doubt?
So what is the moment you can't parallel axis theorem?
Parallel axis theorem, 2 by 5 mR square plus mR square.
Okay. So that's okay.
Any, no doubts, right?